Apparently, the YouTube algorithm desperately wants me to make more Discord-related videos. My most recent video was a flop, so it won't be too difficult to beat it. Hi, I'm Gael Level, and today I want to show you where you can download some Discord emojis in bulk for free without having to sign up. I'm also going to show you how I organize them by color for no reason whatsoever. This video is sponsored by Fatigue. And this is it. That's the website I love using. Discadia.com/emojis. Okay, big disclaimer because the website has none. There's a bunch of emojis that are not safe for work, so make sure you're over 18 if you're gonna access it. All right, and from there, you can just scroll down until you find something you like, or you can, of course, type some keywords in the search bar. It will also suggest a bunch of keywords. But if you're wondering what makes this website special compared to the others, is that, first of all, it has an infinite scroll. So if you reach the bottom, it's gonna load up more emojis under the same tag. But my favorite feature of all time is that you can just click on this one, for example, boom, and it will add it to a queue. It will add it to the overall file that you're gonna download once you're done with it. For example, I want this one, let's say I want that one, this one, that one, that one, and that's 6 emojis. But now, even if I switch the page, even if I close this down, it will actually remember my selection. So let's click on a random tag, reaction, and I can just continue adding stuff. Honestly, I don't even know what the limit is. I've downloaded over 90 emotes at once already. Once you're done with your selection, you can just click on that little arrow that goes up. You can directly rename them from here, which is great. You can download them individually. You can remove some from the selection. You can remove all from the selection. And of course, you can download all at the same time. It's gonna be a zip file, and there it is. So I place it in the right folder. I'm gonna right click, and I'm going to click on extract to emojis. So it's in its own folder. And if I double click, you can see all the things that I selected are in here, and it's that fast. So now if I wanted to add them to my server, I would just go on top of my server here. I would go to server settings. Of course, I would click on emoji, and then I would click on upload emoji. From there, I can find wherever I extracted them, and I can just select all of them and click open. And you'll see that it separates the animated ones from the static ones. From there, we can click escape. And of course, if you click here, you're gonna see your custom emojis right there. Now I want to show you a bunch of emojis that I have on a server, and I want to show you how I display the emotes in the list. In this particular server, we have over 100 emotes, so you can see that they are slightly organized by color. You can see that all the purple ones are together, the pink ones are together, the blue or light blue are kind of together, and then we have the brighter color ones, the white ones. I still need to organize a little bit more. Here we have like the skin tone, brownish colors together, and then we have yellow. So I want to show you how I do this, but we're also going to talk about the downside. Honestly, the only downside is that you have to mess around with the name and they might be harder to remember, like the exact code of the emote. But in my experience, I always click on the menu. I never actually remember how to write any emotes or emojis, if you will. And the way that I do this is by assigning a letter to a color, and then I can put the letter, then an underscore, then the name of the emoji. For example, here you can see that they are not in order at all, but they do have those little things. Like blue underscore is for the light blue or just the blue emojis. PI, for example, is going to be for the pink ones because pink and purple start with the same letter. Y is going to be for yellow. And I know I have an animated one, and I know there's a couple of ones that are not great here. I can put the Y here, and it's going to organize them really well. Now, there's no reason to overthink it. Just separate a couple of colors. I would say 7 colors max if you really have a ton of emojis on your server. So you can basically decide that those are the colors that you're going to separate them by. And then, of course, black and white. So this could be it, even though I know I showed you pink being separate. And if you want a reminder, you can just keep this on the side while you're renaming everything. And it doesn't have to match perfectly. It just has to be the dominant color. For example, this is more like gray, but there's a hint of blue. So I'm going to put it in blue. All right, that took a couple of minutes, but of course, the advantage here is that since you can rename everything before you download them, you can even do this before you even get the pack. So let's see what it's gonna look like once it's in the server. It should be a little more organized. All right, so as you can see, everything is pretty much organized. It's not perfect, but it's the best way to basically organize your emotes so that people can find them easily. Now we have the yellows at the end, and it's perfect. All right, algorithm, I did it. To the humans watching this, if you want to learn more about Discord, I have a bunch of videos on the subject. But if there's something specific you want to know, leave a comment in the comment section below and I will check it out. In the meantime, I have to say thank you so much for watching my video. Go out there, make me proud, get level, out.